What's up, guys, and welcome back to the Chaotic Battles channel. Today, we've got an epic 4v4 sent in from Abadude. It's gonna be at Antietam Cornfield, the A variant, which is north to south. I fast-forwarded about 10 minutes through, just to get to the major action. The only thing you guys missed was some Union cavalry came up here and defended, tried to slow up right wing, or Longstreet's wing over here, and then just a bunch of artillery battles. So here you've got Longstreet's wing facing off against 14th Corps. He's chevroned his 21st Ohio. You got 5th Corps and District going up against each other. And then it looks like two players took 1863 1st Corps, so it's a combined 1st Corps against Left Wing, Army of Tennessee, and Pender's Division. I haven't really had any action over here yet, but probably soon. It looks like the middle, nothing's really happened yet. This is going to be the first of the major action right here. And then probably over there, if I had to guess. So it begins. This should be an interesting fight for this hill, too. Wow, big volley. See a Fairchild volley. Maybe the fire roll. So I got 14 cores using the fence line. Looks pretty cool and cinematic. Good flanking artillery position by Longstreet. The 14th Corps got really good ground right here. I mean, Longstreet's got really good shooters, but 14th Corps great ground. Oh my god. Hey, Zeus. Oh, okay, 14th Corps returning fire hard. We'll see, it's gonna complete the defense line. 14th Corps is in really good position right now. Take that tree line. Getting aggressive over here. Oh wow, 14 Corps can attack him in melee. You don't see that often. Oh, he might not know he is. But it worked, he just walked through him. Oh, he's rolling up district. This 14th Corps artillery is just destroying. Then you got these machine gunners here who are just following every frickin' 5 seconds. Taking a lot of casualties. I don't know if it's the guns or if it's just 5th Corps numbers and the guns. The 14th Corps is pressing hard over here. He's trying to shore up that flank. The 14th Corps is so aggressive. It's really helped out District 2. I mean, it's helped out 5th Corps with 14th Corps being so aggressive. Looks like we still got a shootout down there. District took mortars, that might be it. Oh, it's getting competitive over here, and they're gonna route off the screen, I think. Which is not good for him, because... Oh, I mean, they're pretty far down, though, anyway. 88 out of 207. Strong over here, though. Right wing. Looks like Longstreet's putting out another counterattack here. The 14th Corps is hardcore trying to keep on 5th Corps' flank. Man, this forest fight has been something else. On the front. That fucking ball. Longstreet's wing kind of turned this around. Wow, these guys are like face to face. I think some of this general just went. Or obviously, I think it's a Union general. Oh, Oh, it was 5th Corps. I don't know if he'll come back. There's only 2 men left. Oh, this might be the time. This might be 5th Corps' chance. Unless Left Wing has a bunch of reserves back here, I think 5th Corps can be able to take him here. Be a charge across the whole front. Oh, the artillery! Oh, it didn't go well over here. But it's still going. It's getting crazy over here without a general. He's doing pretty good without a general. Where did Left Wing come from? This front just became very interesting. The 14th Corps is going to have to pull out. Because Longstreet's just walking into him at this point. Good little shootout right here, though. So it looks like the Left Wing is going to come up and put a line up and try to really slow him up. See, there's got to be mortars here somewhere. Yeah, these are definitely the mortars. Oh, massive mortar hit. Because I don't think there's any howitzers over here, unless they're over here in these woods. Mostly a shootout over here. Everyone's getting chevrons. Confederacy is definitely out shooting them, or Pender's definitely out shooting this half of First Corps. Well, maybe not. Is going to try to hold their original position. Fifth Corps is moving in. Although I don't think this will be competitive for much longer. Well, I'm looking at it. He has not lost many men at all. And that artillery is very well placed. What do we have here? They're charging the 21st. 21st is looking no melee.
Yes, sir.
I think the 21st gets eaten up in melee, to be honest with you. Oh, it's pretty even. But in the end, the Confederacy should win this in melee. Or the Longstreet's win should win this in melee. Was getting ready to start pushing them. Yep, here they come. Got that up just in time. I'd say thank God he got him there. If he didn't, any canister coming his way, no delay. Let's see if they can get set up in time to start getting some shots in. Tough for left wing here. He's gonna have to almost like fold his line inward to deal with all of this. And he badly needs Longstreet's wing to get through here. Those numbers are pretty thin. It's been a hard fought fight for him. There's cavalry behind their lines now. Oh, there's the mortars. Probably targeting that cavalry. Oh, it's getting canistered. It's gonna be close. It's gonna be really close.
Come on.
Still got our standard shootout over here. Over here. Close fight. Let me see the whole battle just from here. 14th Corps is doing a good job buying time. Especially now that 1st Corps is finally in full swing and starting to win on the flank. Starting to push in the inside. So close.
Yes, sir.
Looks like first floor is broken, Perrin. Or not Perrin, Pender. Strong, they are tired, and they still haven't routed, and they only have like 40 men. It helped having that 13th from off right there, but they're 46 here, but still impressive they stayed up. Chevrons and all this artillery. It's been an artillery game. Is 5th Corps only infantry unit left, just this 20th Maine? He was like a meat shield the whole time. Just left wing now. So heavy. Although district still got mortars coming in. But it looks like he's got them on fire at will. Or no. Maybe they're not firing? Oh, ah, they're reloading. Are exhausted. See if we get a big volley here. Take a look at some parts of the battlefield real quick. All the action on the right. section through the woods, too. And the fight for this little hill over here. The cavalry fought. This corner here where everyone seemed to fight. And then all of the bodies in here. Big volley coming soon. Fight. to be the end of left wing. Looks like right wing's about to make his final stand. As he takes fire from all sides, pretty much. In one unit. War crimes. Many war crimes right here. War crimes are being conducted. I think that's the lone survivor right there. Oh, are they gonna kill the 18th Alabama to a man? Yep, yes they are. And that's a lot of artillery. Alright guys, that is it. I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward it to the end. Alrighty guys, and that is it. Let's see who everyone played. So Hubs played 14th Corps. Avidude played 5th Corps. Bucktail and Fishy both shared 1st Corps. Lieutenant Bucktail was left wing. Mini Stop was district. DC-37 was Pender, and Rip Van Winkle was Longstreet's wing. Let's see how everyone did. For the Union, Bucktail and Ava did really well. Hubs did pretty good too. For the Confederacy, Mini Stop and Van Winkle did pretty good. Wasn't too much of a unit difference, it looks like. Looks like it was basically pretty even. I think this is Ava Dude, so yeah, his 20th Maine, 44th New York, and his guns did really well. Alrighty guys, thank you for watching.